Hello everyone, I am Venkat Ramaya Kurela. You can call me Venkat Kurela. I'm a cloud neutral trainer and certified consultant specialized in delivering corporate trainings. Also helping organizations designing, implementing and migrating workloads to the cloud platforms. I have delivered hundreds of trainings globally to different levels of students as a freelancer and as an authorized corporate trainer. Azure Administrator is most demanding skill today. It will continue to be demanding skill in the industry because most of the organizations are moving to the cloud platforms. Understanding the industry requirements and understanding the student profiles, I have created a 100% job ready training program. One must have advanced skills to compete with the others. One must have advanced skills to get through the interviews of modern industry requirements. So I've created a customized course, which is a combination of AZ900, 104, and few services from 204 and 300 series as well. The suite of services will help us get a job 100%. Welcome to my course, Azure Certified Administrator. There are 25 modules in this course. Each module is designed specially and carefully. Course starts with prerequisites. Prerequisites are the very basic knowledge or the minimum knowledge that is needed to get started with the course and moves to the fundamentals. Fundamentals is a basic information about Azure services. So you will get introduced to the Azure services and the very basic knowledge of it. For example, what is Azure cloud offering? What is Azure free tier? How you create an account, free Microsoft account? How you log in? What services are free for how long, etc., etc. Then moves to the conceptual understanding of the services. That is where you get a deep dive technical knowledge. The service possibilities, use cases, best practices, etc. Then moves to the labs. Labs are nothing but the real-time scenarios. Every single service in our classes will be a real-time scenario. So we put a scenario, we build the service, we build a solution, and we make it work. Then the module moves on to the certification questions and interview questions. So it's not unlike any other course. Every session will have the certification questions discussed, and I will also be highlighting the interview questions because the modern generation interviews have changed. It's no longer a question and answer. It's no longer a binary question. It's more of dynamic. It's more of scenario based question. So to face such interviews, you must be prepared, and this course exactly does it for you. So you will get a maximum benefit out of this course. For example, if we are discussing about Azure Compute Service, it starts at the server evolution. We will start talking about how the concept of a server born, the differences between the servers and the end user computing devices like laptops. What was the very beginning device of the server era? That's the traditional tower server that you see on the screen. Then industry moved to the rack mountable servers for many reasons, because of the reliability, availability, because of the scalability and ease of management, like how you put them into the racks, you pull them out, if there is any maintenance to be done, the cabling that you do. There are many reasons on why we moved to the rack mountables. We did not stop there. We further moved to the blade systems. Blade systems are the beginning of the convergence, that is to converge the place, the amount of space that we use in the data center to place the servers, that we have converged, that we have reduced. The number of power cards, the number of network cables, the fiber channel cables, and the components that we use, including the fans, the blowers, tremendously reduced in the blade systems. The total cost of ownership is reduced many times. We further move to the converged infrastructure, CI, you call them as. In converged infrastructure, the networking is consolidated. So the fiber channel, the TCP/IP networking, and the other protocols of the traffic is converged into one single pipe. We are not happy yet. We further move to the converged, hyper-converged infrastructure. That's where we have got FluxPort, we've got VBlocks, we've got Nutanix, right? We are not happy yet. We further move to the virtualization, where on a single physical box, multiple virtual machines were running. Not happy yet. From a traditional data center model to the cloud model, where the virtual machines are delivered over the network. We are not happy yet. We further move to the Docker and containers. We are not happy yet. We further move to the Kubernetes. Not happy yet. We move to the microservices. So a complete server evolution. So this is little brief of the server evolution. Now the topic is Azure Compute. So you will understand what different compute options we have in Microsoft Azure Cloud. If we have Azure Virtual Machines, Azure Container Instances, App Service, Azure Functions, Kubernetes, Azure Batch, etc. Being Azure Administrator, being Azure Developer, being Azure Architect, your role will be to understand the application requirement. Your role will be to understand the customer requirement and decide which compute option from Microsoft Azure best suits the need. Once you advise on which particular service to use, you will have to provide a justification on why you advised virtual machines in a given scenario. Why not the other services? You will have to give justification on cost optimization, availability, fault tolerance, security, scalability, in all the directions. Why you advised containers in a given scenario? Why you advised Kubernetes in a given scenario? So it's not just the question or the answer. It's not just a book knowledge that you are gaining, but it is more of a real life scenario. You will have to gain that generalized understanding of the services. That is exactly what we're going to do in our classes. From there, we will deep dive into the technical details of a particular service and into every service. Then we will look into the labs of it. So labs of every single service, and lab is not just a lab, but it is a live scenario. Creating a Windows virtual machine, taking a remote console of that server, how you resize a machine, like reducing or increasing the size of a version to fit to the application needs, and how you delete a particular instance, or you call it as decommissioning. Same goes with Linux virtual machine as well. And it is not all what we do with the virtual machines. There is a lot, but this is just a sample on how it goes. Another example, let's say we are going to talk about storage of Azure Cloud. So it starts at the storage fundamentals or prerequisites of the storage. We start talking about what is data, like we have structured data, semi-structured and unstructured. We store this data into the hard disks. And there are many hard drives again, like SATA, SAS, SSDs, ATA, PATA, many. There are differences among them. You need to understand why we go for SAS, why we go for SSDs. Then we need to scale the capacity and the performance of the hard drives, right? How you scale capacity of a hard drive, MBs or GBs or terabytes, petabytes, hexabytes. How you scale the performance of the hard drive? Well, that's absolutely IOPS and throughput. Then you have got RPMs, the number of rotations per minute, based on which the IOPS and throughput can be calculated. How you overcome the failure of a hard drive? If there is a single hard drive failure or multiple hard drive failures, how we overcome that? Or how we achieve a greater capacity? Let's say I have 10 hard drives, each hard drive is of 1 terabyte, but I need 10 terabytes accumulated capacity. How do I do that? That's where we have
concepts called RAID. RAID 1, RAID 0, RAID 5, 6, 1, 0. There are many RAIDs that you need to understand. It further moves to the storage technologies like DAS, SAN, NAS, iSCSI, FCBOE. DAS is a directly attached storage where hard disks are directly connected to the motherboard using different cables, let's say SCSI cables. SAN, Storage Area Network. The storage system is connected to the servers using the fiber channel network. NAS is storage system is connected to the servers using the TCP/IP networking. iSCSI is of course is an emulated storage that uses iSCSI TCP/IP networking. FCBOE is also fiber channel over Ethernet. Primarily, how you differentiate these storage technologies is whether it is a block storage or a file storage or object storage. So into the block storage in Azure Cloud, we have a disk storage. Into the object storage in Azure, we have blob storage. Into the file storage in Azure, you have got Azure Files. To store the databases, we have got tables, queues, and database storage options like Microsoft SQL, etc. And then we dive into the Azure storage discussions. That's when you get Azure storage deep dive knowledge. That's when you get to understand different storage options, Azure storage options like blob storage, disk files, tables, and queues. In a given application scenario, why you advised disk storage over the blobs? Or in a given scenario, why you advised blob storage over the disks? You need to provide justification in terms of security, availability, performance, cost effectiveness. That is something what we're going to discuss. And then of course, labs of it. Your success is my success. So, I've designed the class framework such a way that it starts at the prerequisites. You see, when we were talking about Azure Compute, when we were talking about Azure Storage, we started talking about the evolution, the very basics of it and where it started. Then move to the fundamentals of that particular service. If it is Azure Virtual Machines, what is that virtual machine service is all about? If it is Azure Storage Accounts, what is this Azure Storage Accounts is all about? Then move to the deep dive subject knowledge. Right, the deep dive understanding of that service, like use cases, the best practices. Right, then the labs or the scenarios, the live scenarios of the services. Of course, it is hands-on experience. Good thing about cloud is there is nothing simulation. It's all in the real environment. The same account that you practice, the same user interface, the same place where you practice will be the place that you will be handling the corporate services. Then of course, the certification questions, like I said, every session we will have the certification questions discussed, so the interview questions. Interviewer may twist the scenario, may twist the question in any way. I bet that my students will be able to answer the questions. And finally, holistic approach. Putting things together. Understanding from the prerequisites until the scenario-based knowledge. Putting that knowledge together, and that's how you crack the interviews.
At the end of this course, you will be able to clear AZ-900 and AZ-104 certifications on your own. At the end of this training program, you will be well experienced on all the services of AZ-900, AZ-104, and some services of 204, and some services from 300 series as well. At the end of this training program, you will be able to create a resume on your own with the real-time scenarios. You will be able to create a resume with real-time projects. You will be able to create the resume points that will make you success. At the end of the training program, if you follow all the topics and have practiced labs of all the classes, you will be able to clear interviews on your own, keeping up to 4 years of experience in your CV.